Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. I am Naufal. Today we are going to discuss regarding quality assurance. Before going to the topic, you should know what is quality. So quality means, suppose if you go to a hotel, in a normal hotel, and you want to have tea or coffee, the price will be very affordable to you. Okay, it will be very cheap. But at the same time, if you are going to a 5-star hotel, for the same tea you have to pay more than that. You have to pay very much, huge amount for a such tea in 5-star hotel. What is the difference? The difference is related to quality only. The quality of the product used in that tea, regarding the milk and the sugar and the tea powder, and regarding the service, regarding the atmosphere, everything will be different in 5-star hotel. Okay, so the price will also will be different. What is the difference? That is quality. They are giving quality. So what is mean by quality? Quality is the meeting need of the customer, both internally and externally. Quality means meeting the need of the customer. The need of the customer will be different. So who is customer? The person who buy a product or who is getting a service is called customer. So meeting the need of the customer, for a normal person and for a celebrity, the need will be different. So quality means meeting the need of the customer, both internally and externally. Internally, the products that are using, and externally the service that is getting will be different. So that is quality. Quality means meeting the need of the customer, both internally and externally. Okay, so what is quality assurance? Quality assurance means a systematic effort to maintain satisfactory performance. You can define quality assurance as a systematic effort to maintain satisfactory performance. For example, a systematic effort is maintained in the hospital to prevent bed sore. Okay, so the patient will be satisfied, he is free from bed sore. Okay, so a systematic effort for what? To maintain a satisfactory performance while performing. A nurse is giving injection or giving any other care, so that performance will be satisfied to the patient. That is quality assurance. A systematic effort. You are taking a systematically effort for what? To maintain satisfactory performance. Okay. That is the simple definition for quality assurance. Systematic effort to maintain satisfactory performance. Okay. Let's see the quality assurance cycle or steps. Sometimes question may be asked as steps of quality improvement or steps of quality assurance and quality assurance cycle. We can see one by one. First one is planning for quality. The first quality assurance cycle start with planning. You have to plan for quality. How to do the quality? What are the areas of quality improvement? Where it is required? Regarding in the hospital, whether it is in the OP department or it in the IP department or in the emergency department. You are planning. Okay. First step is you have to plan for the quality. Second step is setting a standard. After planning, you have to set a standard. Such and such criteria should be met. The staff should perform like this. You are setting a standard regarding the punctuality, regarding the behavior, regarding the service, and regarding the attitude of the staff. You are setting a standard. The staff should perform according to this standard only. So you set the standard in second step. Next one is communication of standard. Now, after setting this standard, you are communicating this standard with your staff, with your workers. You are communicating that we have set some standard in our organization. You have to follow this protocol. You have to follow this standard. You have to work according to this policy only. So you have communicated the standard also. Afterwards, you have to monitor. Monitoring is the next step. You have to monitor the thing. How to monitor? While working, you are evaluating the performance of the staff. Okay, you are evaluating the performance of the staff, whether they are working according to the standard or not. Okay, next step is identify problem and prioritization of improvement opportunities. Okay, after monitoring, you can identify so many problems. Okay, some staff or some departments are not meeting the standard. You are identifying the problem. You identify the problem, then you can prioritize the things for improvement opportunities. Means on which department you have to give importance. For OP department, you have to give more importance in quality assurance, or for IP department, it depends. Okay, so you can prioritize where you need more quality improvement. Okay, next one is defining the problem. Next up, you have to define the problem. What is the problem related to your quality? You have to define it. After defining, you have to organize a team. Organizing a team, you have to organize a team for the quality assurance and quality improvement. Okay, next step is analyzing and studying the problem. After organizing the team, you have to evaluate, or you have to examine the problem, and you have to study exactly what is the problem. Okay, what is the root cause for that problem? You have to evaluate and you have to study the problem. Next, you have to develop solution and action. Next step is developing solutions and actions. You are developing the solution to the problem and you are making some interventions, some action to solve the problem you are preparing. Okay, last step is implementing and evaluating improvement efforts. Here intervention is there, you have taken the action that you are implementing here to solve that problem. You are implementing the things. Okay, you are implementing the solutions, then you are evaluating the improvement efforts. After implementing, changes occurred or not. Okay, you are evaluating. That's all regarding cycles of quality assurance. Next, we can move to the most important part of the quality assurance, that is quality assurance models. Okay, quality assurance models. The most important models in quality assurance. In quality assurance, the most important one for the nurses is ANA model. That is ANA model. First model is ANA model. ANA model means American Nurses Association model. This model is given by Long and Black. Okay, this model is given by Long and Black. This model ANA means American Nurses Association model. Okay, so according to this model, few steps are there. Let's see one by one. First one is identify value. First one is identify value. You have to identify the value. According to this model, some values are there. In a hospital, the values include the patient or client. The patient or client is the value and philosophy of that organization. Philosophy of the organization and the nursing care provider, that is nurses. Okay, they are the valuable things in that organization. According to this model, the values include the patient, philosophy of the organization and the nursing care provider. Got it? So you identified the value. Next step is identify standard criteria. Identify standard criteria. You have to identify the standard criteria. According to the different organization, the standards will be differ. But there will be some standard criteria. Regarding the punctuality, regarding the behavior, regarding the attitude, regarding the performance, regarding the service, there will be some standards in different organization. So to identify the standard criteria is the second step. So how to identify means it is start with writing the objectives and philosophies of the organization. Okay, the standard criteria starts with to identify that writing the objectives and philosophies of the organization or hospital. These are the objectives of the hospital. These are the philosophies of the hospital. So you have to identify that criteria. What are the standards of that organization? Okay, you identified the standard criteria. Next one is, the third step is secure measurement. You have to secure measurement. That means after identifying the standard, you have to measure the performance of the staff. You are measuring the performance of the staff. While they are performing the duty, you are measuring the performance. For example, you can use nursing audit to measure the staff, whether they are working according to the standard or not. That is the third step comes under ANA model is secure measurement, means you are measuring the performance using different tools. I have given the example only nursing audit, you can use a method. Okay. After measurement, the next step is make interpretation. Make interpretation. You have to interpret the result. That means after measurement, you will get a result from the actual performance. And you are comparing that result with the standards, whether the workers met the standard or not. You are comparing the result with the standard from the actual performance while they are performing, whether they are coming punctually or not. For example, I am giving only. And you are comparing that with the standard. That is comes under interpretation. Okay. Next step is identify course of action. Identify course of action. Here you have identified some problem. Okay. In interpretation, suppose you identify the problem that the staffs are not meeting the standard. They are not coming punctual. Okay. So identify course of action means to the problem you have to find out various solutions. To the problem you have to find out various solutions. Okay, alternate solutions you have to find out. That is identify course of action. So many actions you have to find out to solve that problem. Okay, next one is choose action. Choose action. Choose action means from the different solutions, you will have so many solutions. For example, a staff is coming very late only, punctuality is not there. So your solution is you have to deduct the salary is one solution, you have to suspend that staff is another solution, dismiss that staff is another solution. So you have to take only one solution. For example, here we are planning to deduct the salary of the staff. So you have to choose action from the different solutions. Here you made different solutions. In choose action, you are selecting one solution only. Okay. So you selected the action. Now you have to take action. You have to take action. You have to take action means you are implementing that. Now you started to implement that the staffs who are coming late, the salary will be deducted. Okay. So you implemented that action. Implementation is finished. The final step is revaluation. The final step is revaluation. You are evaluating all the things that have implemented. Okay. Again, you are evaluating. Okay. Like this, it will go. This is ANA model, that is American Nurses Association model. It includes different steps. Okay, identify value, identify standard criteria, secure measurement, make interpretation, identify course of action, choose action, take action, and revaluation. Okay, next model is Donabedian model. Okay, next model is Donabedian model. Next model is Donabedian model. According to this model, three things are there. Three things are coming under this model, that is structure, process, and outcome. Okay. structure process and outcome. According to this model, structure lead to process and process lead to outcome. Okay, three things are coming under this model, that is structure, process and outcome. Structure lead to process and process lead to outcome. So we can see detail regarding structure first. Structure means adequacy of healthcare facilities. How much adequately the facilities of healthcare are available, the availability of the healthcare facilities, and the qualification of the doctors, qualification of the practitioners. And regarding the financial aspect of the care, how much amount you have to pay for different services, it comes under structure. Okay, so availability of healthcare facilities, suppose for example in a community setting, whether it is nearby service is there or not, nearby PHC or hospital is there or not, that is availability of healthcare facilities. If at all available, the quality of the doctors, quality of the practitioners, quality of the nurses, and the amount of services, the financial aspect of the care. Okay, that is coming under structure. The things coming under process is effectiveness of the nursing care, how much effectively the nursing care is getting, how much standard is there, how much standard is there, and what is the attitude of the staff. Regarding the client satisfaction also comes under process. Okay, effectiveness of nursing care, standard of nursing care, client satisfaction will comes under process. Okay, and in outcome means the measurement of the effectiveness of the care, measuring how much effectively the care is getting, whether death is occurring, readmission is occurring, or proper discharge is occurring or not, that comes under outcome. Okay, the proper effectiveness of care is getting or not, you are measuring in outcome, that is Donabedian model. According to this model, structure lead to process and process lead to outcome only. Proper facilities available means effectiveness of care will be there, so proper discharge will be there, otherwise death or morbidity will occur, that is this model. Okay, next model we can see, that is quality health outcome model. Quality health outcome model, this model is given by Mitchell and Co. Quality health outcome model. Okay, Mitchell and Co has given this model. According to this model, four components are there, that is system. Okay, system is there, and in system intervention is there, and client is there. Here it will come the outcome. According to this model, you can see these components, that is system, intervention, client and outcome. Okay, system means it will be individual, group or organization. Okay, so you can take example as hospital. Okay, that means system, it will be individual or a group or an organization, and a intervention is giving. Okay, to the client, to the client, the client may be, client may be also individual, family and community. Okay, the client may be, that is the patient may be individual, or it may be a family, or it may be a specific community. Finally, you are seeing the outcome. Okay, you are seeing the outcome. So all these systems, all these things, all these components are connected or interrelated. There is a dynamic relationship between all these components. Okay, all the components are interrelated. That is system, intervention, client and outcome. The system may be individual, group or organization, and the client may be individual, family or community. Okay, so there is a dynamic relationship between all these indicators. Got it? That is regarding quality health outcome model. Next model is PDSA model. Next model is PDSA model. That is PDSA model. PDSA model. This model is given by Dr. Edward Deming. According to this model, P means plan, D means do, S means study and A means act. Plan, do, study, act model. Okay. So, we can see one by one plan. First one is plan. Plan means you are planning for the quality improvement. You have identified a problem. Now, you are planning for the quality improvement. How to improve the quality? You are planning for the quality improvement. Okay, so you are establishing some objectives. In planning, you are establishing some objectives. Okay, next one is do. D stands for do. So in do, you are implementing your plan. You are implementing your plan and you are collecting the data. Okay, you are collecting the data also. In yes, that is study, you are analyzing or you are examining the collected information. Okay, you are examining the collected information. And A stands for act, which means you are taking action for improvement. You are taking action for the improvement, or you are taking a corrective action for the improvement. Okay, that is PDSA model, that is plan, do, study, act model. Okay, finally the last model is Six Sigma model. Six Sigma model. Six Sigma model. Six Sigma model. This model consists of five parts. Okay, the mnemonic for that part is DMAIC. That is DMAIC. Let's see one by one. D means define, M means measure, A means analyze, I means improve and C stands for control. Define, measure, analyze, improve and control. Okay. So, what is meant by define? Defining means you have to define the goals of the organization. You are defining the goals of the organization. M stands for measure. Okay. You are defining the goals and objectives of the organization. Next one is measure. So you are measuring the current services. At present, what the service is giving in a hospital regarding the nursing care. Where you are measuring that service. Okay. And you are collecting the data also. You are collecting the data also. Next one is analyze. After collecting the data, A stands for analyze. You are evaluating or you are verifying that data. You are verifying that results. Okay. You collected the data in measure and in analyze. You are verifying or you are evaluating that information. Okay. Next one is I. I stands for improve, which means implementing the things to improve the changes. You are implementing the things for changes. For the improvement, you are implementing something. Here you identified the problem. Okay, you measured, you collected the data and you verified the result. Something you have to change. So from improvement, I stands for improve. You are implementing something for the improvement. And finally, C stands for control. That means everything will be under control and all the mistakes. Okay, keep it in mind. All the mistakes are corrected before it is reaching to a defect. Okay, all the mistakes should be corrected before it is reaching to a defect. That is control. That is Six Sigma model. Got it? The mnemonic is DMAIC. Fine. Okay, so don't confuse quality assurance with quality control. Quality assurance means it is the systematic effort to maintain satisfactory performance, and quality control means it is the measurement of the present performance and comparing that measurement with the actual or with the standard, and actions are taken. That is quality control. Quality assurance means all the efforts, everything is coming, all the efforts to maintain a satisfactory performance. Okay, so today we have dealt with quality assurance cycle, and the models of quality assurance. We will meet soon with another video. Till that, thank you and goodbye.